All right, we're doing this. I did look up the answer to this. I was planning to look up the answer to this. Oh, okay, I can't. Okay, that's the hard part. Oh, damn it. Squish me. I think once it hits that check, I'm fine. But, okay. I was looking at the coin snake. Jump. All right, sweet. Nope. You solved the puzzle and unlocked a bridge. Congratulations. All right, now back to the third wall level. First, a magical journey. Mansplain Mountain. Breaking the third wall. That's nice that it saves checkpoints. Gotta get back into the groove of this. Okay, a little faster. Hopefully that doesn't kill me. I think this part is forgiving enough that a little mistake like that isn't too bad. pad. No! All right. I was gonna say this is my progress point, but I guess clearly. Oh, I see. Oh, I see. Okay. Does it always do it that way? Or is it following me? Oh, damn. Okay. Alright, it does follow me. That's interesting, I didn't know how those behaved underwater. I would've been fine in the corner there. I still don't have a strategy for this, I don't have a way to like... No! Would've been fine. This is a pretty tough little survival section. Well, that was rude. Oh, I had it too. This is cool. Okay, I think I can just stay there. I bet that control. Can-trol, not control. Sweet! I like the continuity. In with the clouds, out with the clouds. Alright, that's two exits that the concept of made me worried out of the way. And in only, like, 12 minutes. Laser's Lounge, I hope it's Cape. Oh, nice. Oh. I just want to listen to this port. Yeah, I figured it wouldn't end, but... Oh, the headbands, that rules. Holy heck, a pipe. No one's gonna take me. I won't soon forget you were the last person I got to hug before leaving SGDQ. Love ya. Amy. Laser Belch. I love the continuity of some of these quotes. No, we did. Whose can be king?
Don't waste your time or time will waste.
This port is so good. And Mithrillionaire, thank you so much for 10 months of hanging out and just being awesome. Ah! Oh, I did the same thing again. I forget about Muse a lot, but I like Muse. I assume I need that. I also feel like Muse wins the award for biggest sound from a three-piece band. Cause holy heck, you would think there was like an orchestration behind them there. You'd think there's like, I don't know. I just feel like when I learned Muse was a three-person band, I was very surprised. Yeah, I mean, they were never a band I was, like, into, but everything I've ever heard of theirs, I really like. I also, like, when I used to listen to, like, quite a bit of prog rock, and I feel like that, like, they have that kind of prog vibe while being a little bit more catchy. A little bit more, like, approachable in general, you know? Like, I still really like Dream Theater, but, like, I don't know. I just don't have time for a fucking 18-minute song, you know? save it, yeah. I was trying to re-grab over it. This port itself is just blowing my freaking mind. Oh, Jesus, this is hard. I think I should just jump over it that second time. Yeah, there we go. That got me. That got me good. This port is huge! Holy shit! Wow, I'm pretty honored to be the choice over fucking summoning salt. Holy shit. Okay, so I need to jump a little bit. This port is ridiculous. It's like, I don't know if it's the whole song, but it's verse chorus, at least. It's intro verse chorus. Is there a thing with Laser Belch and Muse? I mean, it seems like it. Thank you for saving me. I'm Laser Belch's biggest fan. Okay. Laser played Guitar Hero, and this is Guitar Hero. Oh, okay, I guess that makes sense. Oop, a little too early. Laser Belch is a streamer I like. I just don't think my schedule lines up to watch, but I always, when I do catch him, I tend to enjoy. But I mean, it's the same thing with like I was subbed to Barb for the longest time. Like, if my sub was still active, I would probably have a freaking 5-year Barb sub. But I literally only subbed to him because I would watch his VODs on YouTube. And like, once in very rarely, I would actually catch a stream. You know, the daytime streamers, I don't tend to be able to catch. When I was working as a chef, it would be because I was asleep. No, I should do it right there. And now it's because I'm at work. And it's also tough because then when I do catch daytime streams, it's like all of the daytime streamers that I want to see, I try and like open. Does more speedruns. I guess I have to throw it from, like, here. It seemed like it bounced across last time, though. Because I think that's a block I can throw through. Because this part over here, the Galoomba walks right through it. Vid gave you nostalgic, made you nostalgic and sad because of Wii games. One of your top 5 regrets of all time, when your childhood family stopped working, we sold the games along with the system. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't know how to do this. I don't quite get what I'm supposed to do here. Because it seems to have bounced off. But I will definitely be watching Summoning Salt. I will be summoning the salt this evening. I have no idea. This port is still fucking blowing my mind. Oop. No, I should have gone faster. This is like the most impressive port in recent memory. Alright. If I throw it, it seems to bounce. Maybe I have to throw it from further back? I think this port's pretty old. It could be. I'll just try that. Why? I don't... I'm so lost. It's still cool. I mean, it's not like... I don't know. It's not impressive in the same way of like... Okay. It's not impressive in the same way of, like, some really, like, I don't know, deep layered ports, but just the fact that it's freaking the whole thing. Oh, just a little too early. This has been a super fun hack. Oops. I don't want to jinx it too much, because last time I said it wasn't as cursed as I was expecting. It was a... My Little Puzzles-esque block snake puzzle. And... The third wall level, which was full of... Cloud... P-switch, or P-balloon. Well, okay. Oh, I didn't see that down there. I ended up with two pretty cursed levels last time I said it wasn't cursed, and I'm sure the curse is only gonna get more. We're only opening the proverbial Egyptian tomb. Alright, I must have just been hitting it at a weird spot. You know so little about how music is ported, but you feel like it might be something you would really enjoy doing. Do you know where I could go to get some... I mean, just the standard SMW Central. I mean, there's whole sections about porting. Yeah, I wonder if Shovda has a resource on where the music came from. But, I mean, I don't know anything about porting. Yo, Circus, thank you so much for the good luck. Thanks for stopping by. Although, in retrospect, it's a little funny that I hung out at the opening, like, the front door to this castle. To listen to for longer. No, okay, okay. That's wonky. Knowing, one, how long this freaking port is now. And two, just that... No! Squish me. You know, I was really just expecting it to be like... The tiniest little bit of this song. But I've obviously... This is a pretty tricky level. I've obviously gotten the chance to listen to it. I think was gonna be my number two. Yeah, you just gotta be a little gentle with that there. Man, I got that first try, now I can't do it again, apparently. Yeah, you just have to, like, not give it too much oomph when you... Ooh, too slow. You have to give the Gloom, but not too much oomph. You gotta just kinda stand still, throw it. Otherwise, it bounces. Did. I should just regular jump there. I love all the shoujo emotes in chat today. Shoujo is such a cool person. I am very much a fan of hers. If I can freaking figure out how to work my... There we go. Boom. I guess I could have just spelled that out. I don't know if it's a Twitch update or something, but my emotes look way different than I'm used to. There we go. A little bit of show pride. But yeah, she's a very cool person. Need to go lie down? Oh, Mithril, I'm sorry you gotta deal with that, dude. That's unfortunate. Okay, so that thing stops it. That's cool. Yeah, headaches suck. I really feel for people who have chronic headaches. That just sounds... I mean, I don't wanna... I don't know. I just hate, like, a headache. What happened there? I just can't imagine and really feel for folks who have it regularly. Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, I don't mean to, like, rub it in or anything. I don't want to talk about how much the thing that you know sucks sucks. But I just feel like when I have a headache every, whatever, 6 months, it's like a day ruiner. I can only, it just sounds really unpleasant, and I'm sorry that you have to deal with it. No. I hope the second half's Kate. I said that about the first half. Although this hack does feel a lot more, and I mean it could be, you know, but it feels a lot more like the levels are homages rather than messing with folks, where I feel like doing a Laser Belch Cape level would be messing with him. And I mean, I don't know. I don't know what the relationship between Shoujo and, Shovda and Laser Belch is like. But it's like, the Ampersam level really felt like Ampersam, and and the third wall level really felt like third wall. I assume the My Little Puzzles level felt like My Little Puzzles, but I will never ever play that hack. Damn. I probably could have clutched that, but yeah, just nice and far and no momentum. Oh, goodness, that's fast. I just clipped right through that floor. Oh, I thought I was behind it. Is watching a Ballistic Aristocrat play Buoy Buoy World, and it makes me kind of want to play that hack. I have opened it. I think I technically have one exit because the Yoshi's house has a Reznor or a Buoy Buoy. I remember the first level being a double jump level, and it kind of turned me off. Oh man, that's fast! Maybe it's just one jump. But it looked like a lot of fun. Okay, that was close. Maybe just go straight up and then over. There we go, that's how you do it. Oh, look at that boo. Shovda. You fucking serious? Okay, okay. This isn't bad. It's fucking... it's fucked up. But it's not bad. Nope, two. Oh, that worked. Oh, and that's the level. Okay. You know, I was just thinking. What if green beans were worse? I wish they were worse. Okay. Okay, this isn't bad. This isn't as bad as I thought it was. At first glance, when I saw that fucking... this bullshit. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. I've got the timing for the first jump, it's just the, as I nail Amethyst's head into the freaking spikes. No, not quite. That's one way to do it, is just get out to the outside of it. Oh, that's fast. I can't react fast enough, I don't think. Excuse me? I don't want to do that anyways, because the green bean's gonna disappear. Oh, that's something I need to think about, is how the fuck I'm gonna finish this fight. Okay, that was four little bounces. Keep doing that. Oh, that would have been good too. The fact that Green Bean Castle has made its way into the canon of Thanksgiving feast foods is one of the greatest mysteries to you. I'm sure that I have not had the greatest casserole the world has to offer, but to you, it's a D-tier dish surrounded at the table by A and S-tier dishes. I like green bean casserole. See, I mean, to me, like, I honestly feel that way about most, classic Thanksgiving foods. Like, I don't know about most. But I feel like most of the foods, like the green bean casserole, honestly, the turkey, like, it's just all about tradition. Like, I don't think most people like... okay, I don't want to say most people. I don't, like, ever think about turkey outside of Thanksgiving. And I feel like... I mean, sure. It's a really big bird. Like, you need to have... If you have one turkey, you had better have freaking 20 people eating. Squish. But, I don't know, like... To me, turkey is just, like, bigger, worse chicken. Most people don't know how to cook it well. Most people dry it out. But I like green bean casserole. Damn! It's that last one. I mean, mashed potatoes are good. God damn. Obviously, like, when done well. I just honestly feel that, like, most things that are classically on the Thanksgiving table, I don't think of outside of Thanksgiving. And I'm fine with that. Mashed potatoes, turkey, covered in gravy, and cranberry sauce. Everything beyond that doesn't mean much to you. Yeah, and I mean, I guess it all depends. Like, I have never been a fan of, like, a can of cranberry sauce. Like, if someone's gonna make, like, some freaking cranberry chutney or something, I'm all about that. Damn. But, like, I don't know. It's just, like, to me, mashed potatoes are the only thing that, like, anybody ever eats outside of Thanksgiving. Damn, I had that count too. I'm counting in my head. I'm counting to six. Oh, that was. I must have been way farther to the right. In your family, you often have turkey for Christmas. We did growing up, too, and honestly, like, it wasn't until last Christmas at the meat shop that I realized how uncommon that is. And again, you know, obviously, or not again, but, like, small sample size population. But... We had, like, you know, we sold a bunch of prime rib and ham, but, like, I mean, I always ate, we usually had, like, turkey and ham, but, like, but I thought everyone ate turkey at Christmas, you know, but they don't. Or at least not in... Not the people that shop at the meat shop that I work at. What? How did that happen? I don't understand. I, like, put it down and it shot backwards. But, I mean, I just feel like... I guess I just feel like... turkey is a D-tier meat. You know, it's just one... one year, an aunt of yours did a duck for Christmas, and that was excellent. Yeah, I like duck. I like duck a lot. Oh, come on. Oh, that was just too high. This is good practice for, like, controlling yourself on a green bean. I'd say they're very different. I mean... duck is just all about how freaking, like... fatty it is. In a good way. What? What is happening here? No, I'm good. I like food. I don't, like... in general, it's not something that I'm, like, on or off the clock about. It, like, I'm all about talking about food all the time. But, I don't know, I suppose you could prepare turkey in a way that would be similar to, like, the way you'd prepare duck. But, I don't know, like, I always think of, like... I always think of turkey as just, like, a whole roasted bird, and anytime I've made duck, I've, like, broken it down into its parts. You know, I've cut the thighs or the legs off and, you know, confit those and then seared the breasts and that kind of thing. You know, gotten a nice crispy skin on the breast and... damn. I mean, the big difference, and I don't know if it's just the way they're raised or what, but, like, you can eat duck medium rare. I don't know. I mean, I guess it has more to do with most of my experiences with turkey. I feel like living in a world of, like, professional food people, like, there is a degree of, like, most people can't cook that you end up kinda, like, just living with on the day-to-day. What the fuck? What is happening here? I'm confused. And I just feel like most turkey I've had is super dry, and unpleasant. They're freaking salmonella factories for, like, keeping them around. I don't know. It's probably personal, but... I just feel like the idea of the Thanksgiving feast always is better than, like, actually eating turkey. In my experience. Do I have to hit it in the mouth? Because, I mean, I had it go through it twice. And you know, the fact that most of them don't, that I've had, don't come out awesome, isn't like, I don't know, I feel like it's also a hard piece of meat to cook right. Between the freaking, this is probably a better answer than the one I just gave. Between the size and the considerable heat that you have to cook it to, in order to make sure it's safe. Like, it's a dry, not awesome meal waiting to happen. It's just the worst balance of... Why? What? Oh, if it covers its face, can it not... It's the worst balance, in my opinion, of size and proper cooking temperature. Like, you can have a big old beef roast, but you can cook that medium rare, because you won't die of salmonella, or get disgustingly sick of salmonella. And, like, having a nice juicy piece of fried chicken, or chicken breast, or thigh, or whatever, is reasonable because you don't have to put it in the oven for 6 hours to make it safe. So that probably is my a better, like, objective reason why I feel like turkey is a D-tier meat. Between the, like, safe cooking temperature and size, it's just finding that sweet spot is not easy. That's a better answer as a meat professional than and food professional than just I don't like it. And it's not that I don't like it. I will every year I will happily eat turkey. I can make a pretty good turkey. Usually just experience a turkey dinner to be primarily focused on the gravy. The meat is not really meant to stand out alone. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't think you're off base. I think that's probably more my biases as a professional in food. That, like, I strongly feel like every part of the dish should stand out on its own, and then it also should be better combined together. So like, I want to have the meat good and the sauce good, but the meat and the sauce to be greater than the sum of its parts. You know, No. Okay. At least I know what's going on now. That it's doing a weird eye thing. And I don't think, you know, I certainly don't want to, like, I don't want to present this as, like, I think turkey is bad, or anyone is bad. Like, I am generally a huge proponent of the, like, you know, do you like pineapple on your pizza? Like, who fucking cares? Like what you like. If you like it, order it. If you don't order it. You know, like, I don't want to make it a, like, you know, turkey isn't a good thing. You know, I just feel like in most situations, I would rather be eating something else. Oh, man, that muncher. But I don't know. I mean, I personally always enjoyed the experience of Thanksgiving more than the food. You know, it's like, we had a decent-sized family, you know. My grandma, my great-aunt, microwave brother, soulmate. You know, my great-aunt, her sister, they were always really close. Thank you for the G's. Freakin' Ha came up with most, if not all, of the trolls in this level. You have been warned. Don't like turkey either. Only eat it once a year. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I'm not like, it's just a, you know, that's all it is to me. It's just a C or a D tier meat. Like, to me, it's fine, but it just, like, I don't know. It's whatever. Like, I'd never go out of my way to have turkey anything, and that's just me personally. You know, the turkey gravy is 1,000 times better than the turkey itself, in my opinion. But, you know, it's like, it to me, it was more about the, like, getting together with family and everything. And that's where most of my fond memories from, like, Thanksgiving as a kid comes from. Goodness. This is some shit. That's the not dumb way to do it. No! That's a neat way to do it, though. God, I was overcomplicating that beginning. Stop. Best turkey I ever had was made into a freaking... basically a BLT. With avocado. And it was a really good turkey. I mean, it was, my uncle and I were... I spent it with my uncle in California when I was, like, in between seasonal work, working in Yellowstone and, Jackson, Wyoming for the winter. And we were... he has a restaurant. We ended up helping out, like, the 4-H kids in the area with their turkeys. And... you know, we got some of those turkeys. They were good, like, locally raised turkeys, which is always nice. No! And, you know, we brined it, whatever. Simmered the carcasses to make stock. And it was, like, freaking awesome, like, really nice sourdough bread and wonderful heirloom tomatoes. I keep getting pea speed there. I think that's a troll. I think the troll is, the troll is you get pea speed. Or I could just spin. But that was really, that was a wonderful, that's a turkey sandwich I'd have again. But again, I am a huge proponent of, like, whatever you like, you like. You know, I mean, you definitely, working in the restaurant industry, you get a little bit of that elitism. And I found it came, like, in the kind of middle stage of my career. Where, like, people order something well done, you're like, what a fucking idiot. But it's just like, you know what, if people wanna, like, if they like their steak well done, I'm gonna make sure it's the best damn, like, well done steak they've ever had. Like, you will never, you know... if you've got people that have been eating well-done steaks their whole life, and that's what they like, then, like, that's what they like. And who are you to say that they're fucking wrong? Or that you know better than them? You know, it's all... it's such a subjective thing. Oh, I even got it that time. You like well-done steak as long as it's cooked right. Yeah, I mean, for me, like, most things I eat medium rare. Tenderloin or filet mignon is the only thing I'll eat rare or raw, just because it's tender and nothing needs to be broken down. I tend to, like, given the choice, I will never pick a beef tenderloin, though. It's just... it's expensive because it's small and it's very tender, you know, it's not... I feel like cuts like the ribeye and the flat iron have a lot more going for them. But anyways, like, I would eat tenderloin, also known as filet mignon, rare. Oh, I see what's happening there. Most regular choice grade steaks I will eat medium rare. That's kind of my standard. And then, like, really well marbled prime or Wagyu, I'll eat medium, because you need to really render that. You need to really render that fat out. You need to, like, make the marbling melt into it. Like, that's something that, like, that is honestly something that I have a hard time getting through to people, is, like, we had, this, like, gold Wagyu, which, you know, this isn't Japanese Kobe or anything, This is like an American thing with an American rating system. But their top grade is gold. And it was just beautiful marbling. I mean, not like you see some of the pictures of Japanese A1 or whatever, A5, and it's just more white than red because there's so much fat in there. But it's like some incredibly marbled steaks, and like you hear about people like talking about eating it rare, and it's just like that's just gonna be like you're gonna be chewing on fat. Like you need to cook that more. You know, that is a steak that would be way better well done than rare. Like, and it's hard to convince people of that. You know. Yeah, and it's just one of those things, like, I don't know. Like, burgers, I don't care. I'll eat a burger. I mean, if I know where the meat's coming from, I'll eat a burger at whatever temperature you hand it to me. If I don't, if it's just some random restaurant, I won't go below medium. But, like, if I get a burger that I order medium and it's medium well or well done, like, I don't send it back. I don't fucking care. It's ground beef. You know, it's kind of whatever. It's fine. You know. I think if anything, it's the texture. You know, like, I really enjoy the texture of a medium rare steak, but a medium rare burger is just so, like, squishy. It's not. To me, it's just not, it's not the same. This is a fucking part. Oh, come on. Oh, that was close. But I mean, especially if I don't know where the meat's coming from. Because, I mean, the whole thing with ground meat, too, is, like, you can safely eat a steak medium-rare, because any potential contamination would be on the surface. So, like, you get the surface on the... What? You know, you get the surface onto a 500-degree grill or broiler, like, it's gonna be safe, you know, no matter how rare it is in the middle, it's gonna be safe. But... when you grind meat, the surface is everywhere. You know, so if you have some random, like, not properly handled ground meat, like, I do not want to eat your burger medium rare. Do I go over the top here? I'm gonna get up and stretch my legs real quick. I'll be back in a sec. Thank you. Big stretch. That's what I think it's the law. But every time my cat gets up and stretches, I have to say, "Ooh, big stretch." Oh, I didn't think I caught that. No. Said that with your dogs too. Yeah, I'm sure it's the same for pet owners in general. No. This has been a very cool hack so far. I've really enjoyed this. I don't get it. I don't know what to do here. Oh, neat. Love the FFZ feature where it removes the gap between emotes so you can actually do combos properly. Oh, I don't think I've ever noticed that. Oh, I need to see, like, I heard that affiliates got more emote slots unlocked, and I haven't even looked. I need to commission, like, a bunch of fucking emotes. Is there a spot I can stop early? Because I've got follower emotes. I'm waiting here. I'm gonna see what happens if I wait here. No, it's not that either. There's gotta be one I'm not supposed to step on. Missed it. But yeah, I need to look and see how many emote slots I actually have right now. And I also need ideas for emotes. If anyone has ideas for emotes, I am very all ears. That's the one. That's where it starts. I'm at a loss. I don't know how to not do that. Oops. I have no idea how to not stomp on that block. Yeah, it starts right there. And it eats everything. Maybe I'm not supposed to be waiting here? Although I don't know how I would... Went digging through FFZ settings just now, and the setting is in a weird place. Within the add-on pack, core pack. Is that like a paid FFZ thing, or I don't know much about FFZ and all that. How do I not stand on that? The only thing that's standing out as weird is the little gap I could get into somehow. Totally free, nice. You don't use FFZ, and after being in Barb's chat, you knew it was a mistake. I have FFZ. I just don't do anything with it. I mean, I have some of the cool emotes. I set up some of the, like, freebies as, you know, some of the popular ones as, like, mine or whatever. Oh. Sneaky. I see. So I have the right idea. Closer. Huh. This is wacky. This part is weird. Oh. So if I jump on that, the other P-switch falls. Like the FFC add-on for pronoun though, don't know how other people have them displayed, but the pack is really convenient. Yeah, I just use the, I don't remember the name, it's just some Twitch add-on. I don't think it's, it might be FFC. But my problem is it doesn't show up in OBS chat. So like, I've got the chat that I look at is, you know, it's a window from OBS. But then like off to the left on my monitor, I've got my dashboard. So it's like I can see pronouns on my dashboard, which is like that way. But then, like, right there is the OBS chat, and I can't see pronouns on it. So, I can do a quick glance, like, before I say something like, dude. But, in general, I don't, like, see it right away, and I don't know if there's a way to change that for OBS, which I should look into. Oh, that actually would have been good. Oh, that was close. I wonder if I want to go on top of that. Yeah, it's just one of those things that... Full-time stream viewer, there you go. Hey, that's what I was for a long time. You know, just one of those things I think about from time to time, because it isn't that hard. I literally just have to, like, do one of these to, like, double-check if I... To check or double-check. Taylor, that is that for me, and I mean, I don't know, I think this is a relatively, I mean, this is just as a cis man, but I don't like hearing my voice. It's definitely, that's been the thing to like, that's taken the most getting used to. There we go, yump strats. Oh, there's a hole right there. This is sneaky. This is a sneaky freaking level. I don't even know if that's what I'm supposed to be doing. But streaming is very fun. I quite enjoy it. Gonna start doing speech therapy. Oh, nice. Well, hopefully that makes you... gives you a bit of confidence. Bye. Man, I keep getting stuck at the edge of it. I would recommend streaming for sure. Alright, I guess some of them are coins. You already have an avatar, so you know what your emotes will be. Nice. That honestly is the emote thing is my like freaking like I have I was saying earlier, I have so many freaking emote slots. But I don't know what to do with them. Yump. Oh. I honestly, I have no idea. I have not checked since the update happened. Oh, I didn't get the little thing. I guess I could look real quick. I forget what it's under. Yeah, there we go. No, I have four open standard emote slots. But I don't have any. I have four standard slots. My tier 3 is open. I could do 3 bit emotes. And I have 5 follower emotes. So that's 5, 9, 10... 11, 12, 13 emote slots that I need to fill. And I have no idea. So if anyone has any ideas, I'm all ears. I mean, I'm something, you know, I want, as far as like generic, like a, like one of these, you know, like the, yeah, the one like the full-time stream viewer, like the Shoujo one, or GC7 Cool or Kezcade A, like I like that style of emote. That is probably my most common emote, just because that's what how I usually like when I enter a stream what I use. Yo, a manatee. Can I get up there? This level's a brain buster. Hope you're having a good evening. I'm guessing what I need to do is beat this. Is that gonna kill me after all this? Yep, sure is. Oh, no. I bet I get, oh, okay, I bet I get it. I think I get it. I bet I get one coin then hit the orb, and then I'll stand on the muncher after I get it. I bet that's what I do. Yo, good luck with the them llamas. I hope you find some cool stuff. Nope, I grabbed the wrong one. I think it was just dumb luck last time that I got the one I wanted. This is also, these attempts are the first ones that I'm actually, like, trying to go fast, so that may, it may just be fast enough that I don't have to do any, like, fucking shenanigans. Oops. Poor regrab. I do like the new GC7 crab for sure. I suppose I could do something like Chefy. Like, you know, picture of me, you know, generic white guy with a beard. With a chef hat. No! Am I dead? There it is! That's how you do it. There we go. That was a head-scratcher of a level. But yeah, if anyone has any emote ideas, I'm freaking all ears. Transmissions. Because, I mean, I don't know. I'm not a very creative person. I'm much more of a logical thinker. There we go, GG. I could use a GG emote. I'm going to grab a pen and write ideas down as things come to me. Because I could see it happening while I'm streaming that I'm just, like, talking out loud and ideas come to me. But I do, like, genuinely need to think of several emotes. Mansplain Mountain. Listar Skyway. I did my best to give this level goblin energy. Motor skills are enabled here. You can change jumps in the air. Murr. Listar. I should have seen that coming. Hitting the Fugu helps. Gimme. Kaiza blocked. That was a pretty good read. I'm happy with that. No! Bulleted. Nope. Too early. Or too high. Either one. No. And I mean, I do feel like most of my freaking emote ideas are going to be incredibly generic. And that is too where, like, I've talked to Skytree. Skytree made my, you know, I commissioned her for my first batch of emotes. And she was great about, like, when I said, like, I'm not particularly creative, help me come up with these things. She did. And I told her the same thing this time around. I'm like, I really have no ideas this time. So she's kind of brainstorming a bit. But I don't know. Like, all the best, like, sure, like, everyone's got a GG and a high and a whatever. But it's the cool, like, the cool ones. Like, gee, like, this crab, like, the Glitch Cat crab, like, it's so, like, simple and, like, such a cool idea. Like, I don't know. I have yet to make it to my progress point. No, I missed it. Almost made it. Like a lurk, whatever, something like that. And like, I love my kitty cat, but I also don't... I don't want like 15 freaking Stormy emotes either. Hey, have a great night, Diller. Thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate you hanging out with us. No, I recaught it. I feel like a raid emote would be too much for someone who, you know, as someone who has, you know, generally like 5 to 10 viewer streams, like, I don't know, I feel like the raid is, you know, best used for bigger streamers. Some sort of creative H would be cool. You know, something with a... You know, like a Times New Roman H. Not Times New Roman, like Old English. Or what's it called? Like, how could I do that cool? That would be a cool one. A pog? I mean, I don't know. I feel like that's not my thing, necessarily. But I'm all about ideas. No. I feel like I don't remember who had it, but it was just like a SNES D-pad with the like up direction highlighted. Which I think is great for, like, ghosting up inputs. Which I do from time to time. Fugu's hitbox are so weird. I'm writing down H. Alright, that's three. Only 10 slots to go. And they don't have to all be like, you know, it's like five of them are follower emotes. So, like, I do like the idea of the, like, budget, you know. Budget high, budget nom, whatever. Where it's just, like, a way more poorly drawn version of an emote that I've already got. Which honestly might be funny if I just did that in, like, MS Paint. Like, did a chef hat in MS Paint and made that the emote. Honestly, that's kind of a funny idea. I kind of like that. No, oh, I thought it was regrabbing, but I clicked. A spin jump emote might be cool, like the bottom couple pixels or whatever of Mario's feet and the top of a spiny shell and just that like white cloud that pops up and call it like Om Nom Click, because I always call it clicking, like I'm just clicking down. Yeah, this is what I need to do. I can't just, like, sit there and think about how, like, I suck at thinking of things. I just need to... while I'm streaming, just talk out loud about it. That is something that, I don't know, streaming has definitely done for me. It's like, I'm definitely a person that generally, like, considers his words. Speaking about the AI, I like that. You know, in general, but, like, streaming, I find myself way more, and I had to, like, actively do it at first, but I'll think of some, like, dumb story that happened during the day or whatever, but as soon as it crossed my mind, it's like, well, that's something to talk about, and I'll just start talking about it. Some like dumb story I would never tell like outside of the streaming world, but it has me more like speaking in a stream of consciousness than, you know, and obviously like day to day, you know, you talk or whatever, but I guess in like my day-to-day and working life, I'm a way more, I don't know about introverted, but private person, I guess. You know, it's like I tell work stories on my stream, but I never tell streaming stories at work. Oh, I see. Ooh, whose is that? That's super cool. CO? That's a cool one. Yeah, that's a very cool one. I'm sure someone's done that with a Yoshi tongue. So you'd have, like, the open Yoshi mouth. Oh my goodness gracious, CO Cadelic. We were just talking about your lovely new, Wiggler emotes. Literally, like, the line above. Welcome on in. Thank you so much for the raid. Hope you're having a wonderful evening. What's up, Bun? It is great to see you all. Hope everyone's having a great night. How was the race this evening? I have taken a bit of a break from playtesting ROM Hack Race levels. I'm very, very busy IRL, and something had to come off my plate, and they've got a good crew of testers right now, so... Just taking a break through the holidays. I work at a, like a gourmet meat shop, and freaking Thanksgiving and Christmas are just very, very busy. So I just needed something off my plate. So I'm not as familiar with the race levels as I normally am. But I hope you had a good time playing it. Yeah, I mean, it's not bad. The ending made you a little salty and you're a little embarrassed about it, but I mean, that happens. Salt's part of the Kaizo experience. It's not bad, and I mean, especially, you know, when I think that, whatever, a year and a half, a year and 3 months ago, I was still working as an executive chef and doing 60 to 70 hour weeks, like, this amount of business, this amount of, busy is not bad. It's just that since that big change, like I mark when I started streaming and like started taking time for myself and my girlfriend, you know, that's a big change in my life. Like I was working all the time and like that's basically all I was doing. And now the decision to like take time off from ROM Hack Race playtesting is a lot more to do with if I were to, you know, stream, work, and playtest, that would kind of be all I'm doing, and I wouldn't have time for, you know, good time with my partner and everything. So it's like, I don't know. I'm not overworked, I'm not burnt out, it just kind of, in order to maintain my, like, work, life, partner, everything balance, I just knew that something had to come off my plate. And the fact that I knew that something had to come off my plate. Hey, H. Is pretty solid personal growth. Like, on, you know, like, it took me from, like, 5 years of being an executive chef at this restaurant, and before that, I was an executive sous chef and various other positions. And that whole time, work was like 80% of my waking life, and it took until freaking the pandemic shut down my restaurant for me to see that, like, holy shit, like, there are other things, you know, there are other things to life aside freaking, you know, being a chef for 70 hours a week, and it was a real eye-opening experience. So, like, the level which I'm taking things off my plate now in order to maintain the balance versus what I would have done, like, a year ago or 2 years ago, I would consider it pretty huge personal growth that I would even... You know, my instinct is just to muscle through it. It's just to be like, okay, I gotta get home from a, whatever, 10-hour day of work, and then I'm gonna check the freaking ROM Hack Race Discord on Tuesday, and then on Wednesday I'm gonna stream, and then on Thursday I'm gonna test the new version of the ROM Hack Race level, and, like, that's my instinct, and it's, you know, I would say it's a good thing that I'm at a point where I could look at it as a big picture and just kind of be like, yeah, sorry, one of them's got to go, and we got a good crew of testers, so for the time being, that's what it is, and, you know, once the holidays chill out, and I'm back to kind of my normal work schedule and work business level in general, then, you know, I'll pick it back up. But the nice thing about the holidays, too, is that it's like, oh, that's tough. The nice thing about the holidays, too, is, like, compared to, you know, what I'm talking about, my life as a chef, where basically it was like, this week I'm working 60 or 70 hours, last week I worked 60 or 70 hours, and next week I'll be working the same. Where this, it's like, I know that Thanksgiving, you know, the week before Thanksgiving to Christmas time, I'm going to be very busy. But then the rest of the year is pretty normal. You know, I work, you know, pretty much 9 to 5. And get to have a bunch. You know, the light at the end of the tunnel, it makes it a whole world of difference between what I was doing before and what I'm doing now. But have a great night, Llamas. Thank you so much for hanging out. But before you came in, we were spitballing some emote ideas. Because I've got 5 follower slots. I've got 4 new regular emote slots. I still don't have a tier 3 emote. And I don't have any bit emotes. So, like, my goal is in the near future to commission, like, 13 emotes. That's how many slots I've got to fill. And I'm not necessarily a super creative person, so I'm just kind of talking and spitballing. So far, the ones I probably want to get is, like, is a GG. One of the, like, cool slash, like, A emotes, the, like, you know, because that's my probably most common used. Some sort of H. I like the idea of an H emote. And then one I thought of that I think is pretty cool is like a spin jump emote. That would be the bottom, like, few pixels of Mario's feet or whatever. And then the, like, white spin jump little cloud animation. And then, like, the top part of a spiny. I think that would be a very cool emote. But that still leaves 9 slots. And I'm fine with doing some, like, kind of budget-style ones, like, for the follower emotes. Like, I could do a, you know, a budget, like, chef hat and a budget, like, nom with a taco. No! Oh, I never shouted CO out. There we go. Last seen playing Super Mario World. It's a shocker. But it did look like an interesting race level. I wasn't able to catch, like, a whole heck of a lot of it. But it seemed like a cool concept, at least. That's tough. That Chuck Gate's tough. No, I missed it. I mean, a death block could be an emote. That's an om nom nom cake emote? Like what, like just a cake? Oh, hey! I didn't recognize Pomamel is my lovely partner watching my stream in the other room. Yeah, something food themed for sure, and lurking. Oh, this is a hard Chuck Gate. Honestly, like a chill or like comfy or a cozy, similar, like looking at the shoved sloth. I feel like a cat with its arms drooped over something. God, that's hard. The cat with its arms drooped over something would be very cool. Oh man, that's tough. Since you can't control the speed of the Fugu. I did something earlier that made sense. I just don't remember what it was. Something to control the, like... Maybe I have to hang out on the top one for longer? No, okay, that's good though. Alright, that's three times in a row. No, I tried to back and forth too quickly. Oh, I didn't do the thing I've been doing. Yeah, that's a good way to do it. That's not. Nope, I got stuck on it. No, not quite. I had it for a minute. No, I meant to not jump. Like, I meant to not jump into the death blocks as if that were a, shock. Oops. No! That feels like we're at least close to something. I could use the restroom, so I'll be back in just a moment. Thank you. Yo, Daff! Hope you're having a good evening. No! Fugus have such a weird hitbox. Chillin'. Heck yeah. That is what I intend to be doing. I mean, I am certainly chillin' now, and then I will be chillin' tomorrow. Looking forward to a nice relaxing day off tomorrow for sure. Oh, okay. I think I, like, get it now, at least. I like this music. It's very chill, like, piano beats. Ooh. I didn't need to jump there. Oh, darn. Might have been able to make that if I went to the edge of the hitbox. There. That worked out nicely until it didn't. No! Comfy cozy. Yeah, I think I could use a comfy cozy emote. Try and keep a chill vibe, I feel like it would be appropriate. Oh no! Oh, that's a cool emote. Whose is that? I don't think I know them. But that's a cool hugging emote. Oh, come on. It's not even the hard part. Highly recommend their stuff, Fifi. Fire Dragon, okay. No, I freaking missed it again. I will have to give them a follow. I really like this music. I always appreciate, like, chill Kaizo music. I feel like it can be really easy and, I imagine, tempting to make intense music for your intense hard level. But I feel like chill just, no, chill just is, you know, for music to listen to, like a loop to listen to for extended periods of time. Oh, I thought it was too early. Oh, I forgot. I forgot about motor skills. This is a really easy level to forget that it's motor skills. At least the second part. Oops. I love the death animation and this Amy sprite. Oh, I keep directioning too early. I'm just writing down. Oh, there was one more that I forgot. Chill. That's what it was. Something chill. Well, that's six. That's six ideas for emotes. Got GG, like A, the cool one with the pointing fingers, some kind of H emote, no, spin jump emote with the spitting animation. With Mario's feet, top of a spiny, and the little white cloud that appears. Piece of cake. And then a comfy cozy one. Really threaded the needle there. Oh, I should totally have a, like, chef kiss emote. Like, that stereotypical, like... Hold on. Oh, I need to go under that. That's obviously not right. Like the, like whatever. Like, I think there's a global emote that's something like that. Or it's just something you see around all the time. But do that, except with my, like, general likeness, or at least as close as you can get with the... within the confines of an emote. Making good progress on the, I'm definitely more focused on trying to think of emotes than I am on this level. Although I'm pretty focused on this level. But that's, like, that's my goal right now, is come up with a bunch of cool emotes, since within, like, a 2-week period, I unlocked follower emotes, and then affiliates got extra slots. So I suddenly have quite a few slots to fill. No. Did. Either way, I wasn't gonna make it through that gate. I should have known that goal was fake, seeing that there was nothing after it. But it was too tempting. This hack is so cool. I like this hack a lot. No. Oh, and then I go to that one and ride it over further. Okay. Oh, I thought I was gonna squeak through. No! Oh, that was close. No! Got the re-grab instead of the jump. That's unfortunate. Comfy cozy. Glad you're having a comfy time. Oh, come on. Ugh. Threading the needle. They're so, like, packed close together that it seems like it's hard to do, but with the freaking Fugu hitbox that only, like, part of it is really what you can stand on. These seem close. I think I spawned that weird that time. Because those seemed closer together than normal. That was close. It's a wonky ending for sure. Yeah, I should have known. No, damn it. Just off. Oops. Oh, I was worried I went too early there. Oh, fucking discos. I am also bad at discos, so it's probably my fault more than the disco shell's fault. Oh, damn it. No! That's what I need to do. I just need to get on it and turn it that way. Yeah, I didn't think so. That was a tight little squeeze right there. Ah, I knew. I shouldn't have gone for that. I should have taken one little jump after I realized what my momentum was doing. Big. I've been threading that needle so well, it was bound to happen. No, that was way off. Hey, glad to hear, Mithril. Glad you're feeling better. We were brainstorming some new emotes, since I have a bunch of emote slots to... I have a bunch of emote slots to fill. Or at least that's what I've been trying to do. I didn't think so. So, a GG, an A, like a GC7 cool style, Some sort of H. A spin jump emote that shows the bottom of Mario's feet, the top of a spiny, and the little white, like, poof that comes. Piece of cake, which fits with the food theme. Some sort of cozy or chill one, and then a chef's kiss, like, you know, except with my, you know, bearded face. No! I wonder if I can lead that one out there. This is a hard ending to this level. I was hoping it would turn around faster. And then I can fill in some of the follower slots with, like, the budget kind of things, like a budget nom, budget, Stormy with a taco, budget hat. But between unlocking 5 follower emotes, dead, 4 new emote slots, bit emotes, and a tier 3, I have 13 slots that need filling. 14 if you count my tier 2, which is just a placeholder picture of Stormy. No. Been considering your route in Grand Poo World 2. Think you're going to backtrack and knock out the path you didn't take before you go to the in jam banger emo. Oh, that's a good idea for sure. We're writing that down on this lovely piece of junk mail that I have near me, although I shouldn't show that on stream. Necessarily my real name and address. Good thing I just, you know. Yeah, that's a good idea. So are you still on Deuce Lair? How has that been going? Because this one sure is a fucking banger. Beat Deuce Lair. Hey, congratulations. I mean, that's what I did when I beat whatever it is. I don't remember the level before, and then Toasty Coals, and then went back through and did whatever it is, Arrakis and Yacht Club Castle. But I did them. I had both of those knocked out before Sen's Fortress and whatever all that business is in there. Oh man, I need to just go. I should not be focusing on that particular Fugu. Which path did you take? Toasty coals does suck. And I mean, honestly, the Thalassophobia main exit rocked my socks, too. I think I did the main exit first. I don't remember, though. But I had beaten both Toasty Coals and Yacht Club Castle before going to that, whatever the fan level is. That there are just a couple bits about Toasty Coals that sucks. I don't think, like, what I would say, my opinion, was that I thought Toasty Coals sucked until I played Deuce Lair, which gave me a whole new insight as to how levels in Grand Boo World 2 could suck. And I mean suck in a very kind, it's just a brutal, brutal level. Yo, Snake! How are you doing this evening? So I think if you're comparing it, and this is obviously all personal, but I think Toasty Coals with Deuce Lair behind you would be a way different experience than Deuce Lair or Toasty Coals with Deuce Lair ahead of you. How was the how the race treat you tonight, Snake? I didn't get to watch a whole lot of it. You had an easier time in the second half of Deuce. That is the opposite of my experience. For me, the first half of Deuce Lair was hard, and then the second half was just straight demoralizing. Like, I think that is probably the level that, you know, overall for my entire Kaizo experience that I was happiest to be out of. To be done with. Mostly because of the second half. The first half, like, figuring out the falling statue was a bit of a bitch. No, got too far ahead. Took you a while to get through the key tech, got the raid, finished it through the raid. Well, congratulations. GG on the finish, for sure. No! Yeah, I mean, honestly, it's the second half of Deuce Lair that, like, still makes me, like, apprehensive about running Grand Poo World 2 back. Oh wow, I don't believe I survived that. God, this ending is brutal. Dead anyways. But Deuce Lair was one the second half that I got to, like, pretty close to the end, like, relatively quickly. Like, not really quickly, but relatively quickly for, you know, compared to the rest of my Grand Poo World 2 experience. But then, actually beating it, actually, like, having the consistency to freaking... Man, that was good. But I need to get that lower than the goalpost to go under it, and then guide it over to the right. I assume. That's as far as I've been, but... That makes sense. No, I got the re-grab. That's the worst. But, like, actually finishing it, like, I mean, it was several hours from... first getting those, like... Oh, shit. The, like, to the one-tile pipes that you have to jump off of, to actually getting the pipe. Yeah, Fugus are weird as hell. Especially, like, in this, is there's just, like, a really specific way you have to do it. Like, you can't start it too high. I wonder if you can do it with that first Fugu. God, why didn't I do that before? Jesus Christ. Well, I feel like a fool. I should have done that a long fucking time ago. Thank you for the G's. We'll take a look at this. I don't know how... Honestly, it's gonna depend. Like, I mean, I'm off tomorrow. I'm just chilling tomorrow. So... how much this level sucks me in is going to determine how much of this level we will play. Maybe we'll beat it, maybe we'll look at it for 10 minutes. It is getting pretty late for me, but we'll see. We are going to hydrate. Thank you for the G's, Muscly Chuck. That is a solid emote. 2, 4, 6. All right, we got 8 emote ideas. I love it. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, no, we got a pipe. Ooh, I can have 2 shells. Oh, obviously I kept it. Hi, Amy. Thanks for being the reason I got into Kaizo and streaming in the first place. It's... been an amazing experience getting to grow alongside you. I'm so glad to have you as one of my best friends now. Never forget what an impact you've made on the people around you. The world is a better place thanks to you. That's a very sweet one. A lot of different tones. If anyone hasn't seen it, this hack, all the levels are like an homage to a particular streamer or person. And they all have a quote in the beginning, and some of them are cute, some of them are sweet, some of them are funny, some of them are tongue-in-cheek. It's cool to see. It's cool to see all the different, like, you know, relationships folks have. Interesting. Oh, I needed that. I guess that's obvious that I would, but... neat. I like how it stops at the death. That's great. This is an interesting fucking level. This might be too brainy for me at this level of night, at this time of night. Located entirely within my kitchen. But we will see. Do you come back? I thought so! I thought it was- it looked like a vine. My first instinct was that it was just a recolor. But no, it's a vine. That's wild. So do you think I shall jump over? Eh, I'll just jump on it and see what's next. I bet this came from the fact that she couldn't get the thing to stop spawning. Excuse me? You know, this feel, I mean, it's very cool, but my guess, as I become more, like, aware of the creation process, at least, is that that was a trick that came out of the fact that the bat and shell kept respawning. So something had to be done with it. Was that vine there? Has that vine there been there the whole time? I'm confused about this. I don't know if we're gonna make it too much longer, chat. What is happening with these vines? Hey, that's gotta be just a symptom of having a freaking vine on a sprite stack. Yeah, because something keeps popping up. Yeah, I think that the vine may have some unintended interactions with the sprite stacking. I agree. I mean, that's gotta be what it is. Okay. And we already know that she knows that when you go back and forth, shit happens. So I wonder if that's there to make that happen. Oh yeah, look at that. Maybe that's what's supposed to happen right away. Oh, I bet I disco it. I bet I disco it is what happens. It's yellow. I bet that's what's going on. Yeah, that's gotta be what's supposed to be happening. Oh, or... Okay. I bet it's totally unintended that that fucking vine pops up now that I see that you put it down and it grows. Like, that is what is supposed to happen. Little tap. It's a wonky-ass level. That's funny. Take it. Well, I gotta check. Okay. Oh, I see now. I see what the footballs do. That's a big fucking brain troll right there. Oh, I bet I'm fucked. Oh no, I'm not. Oops. No. I like that they respawn. I wonder if you have to, like, kill both sprites for it to not come back. Oops. I mean, I don't know. I don't know a darn thing about freaking sprite stacking. Oops. Well, I do appreciate everybody coming to hang out tonight. Hope everyone's having a wonderful Saturday. Oh, I need a little bit of momentum there. Oh, and that I gotta kill the bat. And... oops, I wasn't looking. Kill the bat and freaking aggravate the Chuck. There's a lot of, like, sneaky trolls in this hack. A lot of very unique trolls. Oh, that's probably bad. Well, maybe. Getting hit with the football is bad. Oops. Not jumping is bad. This fucking rules so hard. I don't like the low ceiling. What's gonna happen here with the low ceiling? It's the goal tape. Oh my. my god, that rules. Oh, that's so good. Oh my god, that's so good. I would love if someone doesn't mind a clip of that. Oh, that's one of the most like best genuine like oh my god, like laughs I've gotten out of a Kaizo fucking anything. Oh, that's terrific. Oh my god, that's so fucking funny. All right, hashtag free shoujo. Mario Maker. This Goomba is shoujo. Help her escape Mario Maker 2. No. Well, we're gonna keep going and see. Oh, we won't be able to without Shoujo. Thank you. I think this is a. I think the Goomba escort mission is a good time to call it an evening. Thank you all so much for hanging out. Let's go find someone playing SMW. Oh, I should start select and move on the overworld, because that saves. I mean, I assume I'm saved, but we're going to do that anyways. So let's see who is playing the old Smoo. It's TJB. We just raided TJB. But they are just the first person I saw. Let's see. Yeah! Thank you so much for hanging out. I appreciate everybody. Let's see. Halcyon. Have we raided Halcyon up late? I don't remember. There isn't a lot of. I feel like Saturdays I generally have to, like. Let's go raid Halcyon. I don't remember. Did we just raid Halcyon last weekend? Well, I'm gonna go browse real quick. We might have just raided Halcyon last weekend. But I don't remember. Yeah, either way. I like to spread it around, but if not, I mean, I'm not gonna spend too much time trying to find a raid target. But I'll look at the old find a new friend tab. Oh, there's some Japanese relay going on, it would seem. Oh no. Yeah. Which, I mean, I'm not gonna raid a random. Let's see, there's Kai Parasite is playing Luminescent. Prestonator. I recognize Prestonator, and I'm not following. Let's go to Prestonator. Who is also playing Luminescent. Let's go there. Well, thank you all so much for hanging out. I always feel like my Saturday streams are on. Oh yeah, that works. I just dropped him a follow. I feel like my Saturday streams are always the best ones. It could be just because it's the end of the week, but it's like, you know, I appreciate everybody. Appreciate everybody stopping by. I definitely won't be doing a weekend stream or a Sunday or Monday stream this week. I've just got too much going on at work. I'm working Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday before Thanksgiving, and it's probably going to be long-ass days. So next time we'll be back is on Wednesday, unless I'm just beat to shit from a week of very long days. So that's sort of up in the air. But either way, thank you so much for hanging out. I always appreciate it. Thank you for watching me play Mario and listening to me talk. And I'll see you next time.